Yeah, teach us how to destroy ourselves, how to be crabs in a bucket to one another. Yeah, he good at that, Connor. He real good at that. Yeah, that's why he put the woman in control of everything.
There you go.
That's why he put the woman in control of everything. God ain't about that. God says, this is the order out of the Bible. You got God, Christ, the man, and then the woman. No, a woman ain't supposed to be in charge. Let's get that in Timothy. Get the order.
Right.
Says Adam was the first created, then Eve was created.
Right.
You know, and then they try to say, though, man. Well, y'all nigga.
Woo!
White man ran through the wood like he on safari. Now you on safari. Like, look at these Negroes. Look at these Latinos. Look at these wild beasts. That's where they looking at. Look at them.
Exactly.
Well, I ain't from L.A., but I've been out here a while. But I remember a couple of years ago, you wouldn't see no white people rolling through the hood like this, man. Yeah, just rolling through like they Beverly Hills or some crap. I like they Malibu, yeah. I saw a couple of them jogging last week. Over on Crenshaw.
Got all the blood
rest. Yeah. See? Like the brother said, I forgot all about Reginald Diddy. Yeah. And you said about Negroes, when the black man do what they did with Trayvon Martin case, don't destroy your own neighborhood, Negroes.
Right.
Don't destroy your own neighborhood. Tell your kids, don't destroy your own neighborhood. Destroy the white man crap. Yeah. Take it out on him.
Right.
Don't take it out on your own neighborhood.
Right.
Yeah. You destroy what you got. You destroy what's around you.
Ooh.
Yeah, you destroy this. A white man gonna let your butt come up in Beverly Hills and shop. You can't afford it anyway. Yeah, don't destroy your own neighborhood. Yeah, do a rational things on their butt. And do your best to do it undercover. Don't tell too many Negroes now. Cause master the white man, get him, they'll squeal on you. They'll squeal on you quick as hell. Hell, you do it in secret. That's what Moses did. What you call that? Moses did that righteous kill.
Yeah.
Moses did a righteous kill. One of his brothers still snitched on him, ran him out. Yeah, Moses, you killed the Egyptian? Yeah. Yeah, Moses killed the Egyptian trying to help another brother out. And then they turned around, told Moses, I can't remember how it go, but they was like, Moses, you killed an Egyptian. Tell him about Moses.
Snitched.
Yeah, snitched on Moses. Moses had to get the hell out of Egypt.
Yeah.
Pharaoh found out, yeah. Right, it was only three people, like the brother said. Moses, the Egyptian dude is dead, and somebody else saw it, but it made it all up to the Pharaoh. That's like you killing a white man, and then the next thing you know, Barack Obama knows you don't kill the man. Barack Obama talking about it. Yeah.
Armed forces.
Yeah, Barack Obama talking about sending the whole armed forces at you because you don't kill a white man.
Right.
That's the comparison to today.
Well, they'll do it.
What happened with Moses.
We'll do it.
What you got?
Order.
Yeah, go ahead. Yeah, read that. This is the order of the Most High and Yahweh Shai set up. This is another reason why Christ in the Most High says, love not the world, neither the things or the ways of this world. Because everything is out of order.
That's right.
Everything is out of order. You got a man want to be a woman.
Right.
A woman want to be a man. You got people getting their sex changed.
Right.
A man can change from a man into a woman. A woman can change into a man. It's all confusion right there. That's why Christ says, love not the world, neither the things that are in this world.
Right.
It's all confusion.
That's right.
This world is dealing on a feminine vibration,
yeah.
A womanish vibration.
Right.
But this is the order. Christ didn't say the man and the woman was equal. Christ didn't say the man is 50-50. Christ didn't say that. God didn't say that. God didn't set it up like that from the beginning.
Right.
We don't get strap on a ditto and trying to have sex with another female dog.
Right.
When have you ever seen that, brother?
That's right.
You ain't never seen it. So what the hell are the women doing trying to do it? You see what I'm saying? Yeah, brother, you're right. It don't make no sense at all. If If they mama would have did what they were doing, they wouldn't be here. Cause a woman strapped on a dildo sleeping with another woman. Thank you, brother. Most high, your house shall bless you. A woman strapped on a dildo sleeping with another woman cannot produce a baby. A man going up in another man's rear end cannot produce a baby. That's why if the two faggot men, if that old man, they daddy would did what they did, they wouldn't have their asses here right now. Yeah, it's the devil. It's the devil. Is it wicked as hell, brother? Yeah, America promotes that.
Right.
Yeah, it's just like the brother said, it's Satan time right now. That's why the earth is getting into the hand of the wicked. Read that out, 1 Corinthians 14:33.
For the Most High is not the author of confusion.
The Bible says the Most High God is not the author of confusion. God is not the author of confusion. So if you're a woman sleeping with another woman, God ain't down with you. If you're a man sleeping with another man, God ain't down with you, because it's all confusion. That's why you laughing, sisters, because you know it's right. It's true. Hell, it don't make no sense at all.
Can't tell these days, this is that. Can't tell.
Hey, I was reading an article on the internet about two weeks ago, and they said in this article that more parasites are passed between one man going up on another man's rear end. More parasites are passed between those two men than anything. See what I'm saying? They say he might as well take his hand. That's what we're going with. They say he might as well take his hand and take his rod and dip it in some toxic waste. See what I'm saying? They say it might as well do. And then they turn around and said, no matter how well you cook pork meat, you cannot kill the parasite that's in the pork meat, no matter how well you cook it. Because those parasites were created by the Most High God to be in that meat, to help the pig out. And that's why a pig can eat anything. To help the pig do his job. That's why the pig can eat anything and it won't kill him, because he got those parasites in there to back him up.
Right.
See what I'm saying? But then when you eat the pork, you get them parasites in there. Them parasites that's in that pork was meant to be in your body. That's why they jack you up. That's why you can Google it on the internet, and you can find people got parasite worms in their brain from eating pork. See what I'm saying? All over their brain, eating their brain up. See what I'm saying? And then the scientists turn around and say, no, I'll go there. If you're a faggot and you eat pork, you doubling up on the parasites, you doubling up on the toxic waste. Man, yeah, that thing tripped me out, man. That's what the scientists said.
Wow.
Yeah, they said, tell me they got a mental problem. Yeah, you got a mental problem. You got them parasites, them worms running around your brain.
Right.
You
know
what I'm saying?
Right.
They said, but you eat pork and you a faggot, you doubling up on the abomination, you doubling up on the parasites. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, they said, basically, the scientists said you might as well go and kill yourself, man.
Twice
the abomination, man. Man, but it's on the internet, man. That's why I read it from the top again.
1 Corinthians 14:33. For the Most High is not the author of confusion.
The Most High God of Christ ain't dealing with no confusion for you Negroes and Latinos. You gotta come back to this word.
That's right.
Come back to your wisdom. Come back to the wisdom, knowledge, understanding that's found in the Bible. Come back to this word. Come out of the ways of America. Come out of the ways of this society. Since Most High is not the author of confusion. Go ahead.
But of peace.
You can only get peace through these scriptures for you black and Latinos. For you 12 lost tribes of the nation Israel. You can only get peace through these scriptures. Now you know how to put everything in it right perspective then. You know. That you don't gotta sell out to this world, sell out to this society to get a piece of the American pie, which ain't nothing but a piece of the devil's pie.
That's
it. So I'm saying, you know that. You know you can just live. It's okay, brother. Yeah, just live within your means and live within your needs. You don't gotta try and impress everybody by getting a car you can't afford,
right.
Getting a house you can't afford, buying clothes you can't afford. You see what I'm saying? Trying to go out balling to the club. Think you can buy the bar out, broke as hell, you see what I'm saying? You can live within your means. You don't gotta try and please every damn body.
Right.
And that's what the scriptures is about. Hey. Now look at how many our people had on the how much money and still wasn't satisfied with himself. Michael Jackson, the perfect example. You see what I'm saying? Billionaire. Had all kind of money.
Right.
Had 100 plastic surgery done and wasn't satisfied, happy with himself. Look at that, get them out, get them. Look at that.
There it is.
They're on safari.
Safari.
They're on safari through the hood. Let's see what these niggas are doing. She got it, Bob. Check them out.
There you go.
Got these niggas
there you go. He right. They know him. They know what we talking about. There you go.
Hey.
They know
well, watch out. They going to do a rest of penny on your butt.
Every night,
You see what kind of, that's the second time they all came through here,
right,
man. Just cruising, man.
Second time.
What kind of mess is that, man?
That's Esau flooding up, baby.
Where the stick-up kids at? Man. See, man.
See all that confidence Esau got?
Huh?
All that confidence.
Yeah, you're right, but confident. He know he's in his kingdom. This is rulership right now.
Right.
You know the earth is given to the hand of the wicked. See what I'm saying? Man, that thing is funny, but it's true and serious as hell, man.
Yeah, you're right.
Brother brought a good point. So-called Negroes are better. You drive to Beverly Hills, you'll be rolling around Beverly Hills like that.
Right.
Yeah. Police will be on you so fast. Yeah, the police will be all over you. Well, probably people probably walking down the neighborhood in Beverly Hills, see you drive through there, hop on their phone.
Right.
Call 911.
Right.
Grab their purse and lock all their doors. Call 911 on your butt.
Yeah.
But the white man rolling like he's rolling through the jungle, like he's in Africa somewhere. Checking you Negroes out, boy. They said we the entertainment of the world. Crockett got bored with one another. Like, we need to see some action. We need to see some entertainment.
On the wild safari.
Well, but man, let's go down there to where the niggas live over there.
Right.
South Central.
We don't have no born signing.
It got no business
down here, man, at all.
Top down.
And see, then, if something happened to him, it'll be on the news.
We don't know what happened.
Why did it happen?
Right.
It's like I saw, I'm getting away from the scripture right now, but it's kind of like I saw a gazelle running and he jumped into the midst of a pack of lions without knowing them, man. But you're in the wrong spot. That's why something's going to happen to you, man. Okay. Wrong place at the wrong time, wrong things happen. Let's get back to the scriptures, dog. Man. I don't even know where to go. What scripture to go to after that, man.
He got it on camera, though, huh?
Yeah, man. Esau getting brave as I don't know what. Esau's the biblical name for the so-called white man, for your so-called Negroes and Latinos, for you ones don't know it.
Totally.
He was made and created by God and Christ to be your enemy. Go to the Apocrypha, which says, shores and rusted to show your enemy, in Ecclesiastes. See, you want to change something that's unchangeable for you so-called Latinos, you so-called Negroes, the 12 laws, tribes of Israel. You trying to change something that's unchangeable. Just like you said it's okay to eat pork, shrimp, crab, and lobster, and catfish. You trying to eat something, change something that God says you're not supposed to eat. He made it for us not to eat. So you trying to change something that's unchangeable.
Right.
What's meant for you to eat those things.
Right.
Yeah, you can't reach it right now and change the sun into blackness.
Right.
See what I'm saying? So you can't change what the Most High in your house I created. Yeah, you can't change the Most High in your house I purpose. You can't change it, Negroes. You can marry all the white people you want to, go to their schools, let them be your best friend, all you want to. You can't change that man from being your enemy, for you blacks and Latinos. You can't change the white man from being your enemy, because your heavenly father, God, made that man to be your enemy.
Yeah, he just be a wolf in sheep clothing.
That's all.
Every now and then he flare up. He flare up. Trayvon Martin was a flare up. See what I'm saying?
Indeed.
Rodney King was a flare up. You see what I'm saying? Showing him that he's your enemy. It was in some state. Most I make him do it. Show that he's your enemy. In some state, it's all, Google it. Google it, white cop kick black woman in the stomach that's 9 months pregnant, kick in the stomach so hard the baby took a crap inside her womb. Google it, Negroes.
Get an emergency.
Google it. See, that's why we say you can't make him be your best friend. The Most High God made him your enemy.
Yes,
that's why we read earlier. See him many things, but you deserve his not. That's why the scripture said that earlier. We're going to go there. Read this, and we're going to go there. Go ahead.
Ecclesiastes 12 and verse 10. Never trust thine enemy.
See, the Bible says never trust your enemies. But hell, you Negroes don't know who the hell your enemy is. Right. We're trying to tell you that the white man is the public enemy number one.
Right.
Not your people that you live amongst here. Not your fellow brothers and sisters, the blacks, Latinos, Native Americans, Argentinians, Chileans, they ain't your enemies. The white man, the Japanese, the Chinese, the Arabs, the East Indians, and the Africans is public enemy number one. But the white man is top of the list. He's right. Number one. See what I'm saying? Y'all don't want to believe that. Y'all don't want to hear it.
No.
All right, white man, there's some good white people out there.
Right.
Now, they had a saying when I was growing up, the only good white man is a dead white man.
Right.
That's what they used to say when I was growing up down south.
Right.
See, y'all need to go down south.
Right.
And then let the white man deal with y'all butt down there.
Right.
And you'll know, because they don't hide it down there.
No.
Call you a nigga in a minute.
No. That's right.
And tell you we'll take you such and such place and hang your butt up.
Right.
If you say something back.
Right.
Yeah, y'all got to water down white man out here.
Right.
Yeah, y'all got the wolf in sheep clothes down here.
Right.
But they fly up out here too now. Go out to the valley. Go out to the valley or go to Beverly Hills. Read that, I'll start from the top again.
Never trust thine enemy.
Scripture says, never trust your enemies. God and Christ made the white man to be our enemy. You should never trust him. Go ahead.
For like as iron rusted.
Says, like as iron rusted, no matter what type of chemical or what type of paint, they make to put on iron gonna rust. Over a period of time, it's gonna rust. You cannot put anything on to stop it from rusting. Yeah, you can put 100 million coats of paint on it, that iron gonna rust. Sooner or later, it's gonna rust. Says, never trust your enemy, sure it's iron rusted. It's, go ahead.
So is his wickedness.
So is his wickedness. Yeah, we met a brother about 3 years ago, King and Crenshaw, was teaching over there. He was listening to us teach. He was like, man, y'all right. He said, I was married to four white women. He said, sooner or later, all of them called me a nigger.
Yeah. Wow.
Yeah, sooner or later, all of them called him a nigger.
Wow.
But they supposed to love him. They supposed to be united in holy matrimony until death threw them apart. He ended up divorcing all four.
Early next week.
See what I'm saying?
Take care, huh?
But that's what scripture says. Never trust your enemy. All right, choose iron rusted. So your enemy gonna count on you sooner or later.
All of them, no matter what, man.
They just waiting on that with the right opportunity, man. That's all they wait, though. Yeah, you can't stop it.
Woo.
Go to Job 14 and 4. Job chapter 14 and verse 4. See, but you want to love this man, you want to walk with him hand in hand, want to have him for your best friend, you see what I'm saying? But you don't know who or what you're dealing with. That's what you don't know. You don't know that you're dealing with your enemy.
That's right.
Because you don't know the scriptures. You don't know the ways of your heavenly Father. You don't know the ways of God and Christ. That's why you know who your enemies are, Negroes. That's why you don't know. Yeah, Job 14:4, read that.
Job 14:4.
Who
can bring a clean thing out of an unclean?
Bible says, who can bring a clean thing out of an
unclean
thing? See what I'm saying? Yeah. You can't bring nothing clean out of some crap, out of some dog crap, can you? I know some people in other nations out there trying. So you can't change nothing from the way the Most side in your house I made it to be and created it to be. Go ahead, read that.
Ecclesiastes 7 and verse 13. Consider the work of the Most High.
Consider the work of the Most High, you Latinos and blacks. Go ahead.
For who can make that straight?
Who can make that straight? How can you make the so-called white man straight? Go ahead.
Which he hath made crooked.
The Most High made him to be the wicked.
That's right.
The Most High made him to be wicked. To play the wicked person on the face of the earth. They made him to be that way. So you can't make him your friend. You can't make him your husband. You can't make him your wife. You see what I'm saying? You cannot make him to be a good person. Not only the white man, but the African, the Arabs, the Chinese, and the Japanese, all the other nations. That's why it's so important to deal with our people. Huh? Good. That's why it's so important to deal with our people. Then we deal with our people, better know these scriptures too. Because a lot of our people have been influenced by the people of the other nations. Shit, they are worse than the other nations are. Go ahead.
Ecclesiastes 1 verse 15. That which is wicked,
that the Most High your house I made crooked, go ahead,
cannot be made straight.
You can't make it straight. No matter what you do, how much you pray, how much you go to church, you cannot make your enemy, the white man, be straight or be good. No matter how many jobs he give you, how many raises he give you, let you move into the suburbs with him, you see what I'm saying? Let you marry a white woman, let you marry a white man. He's still gonna be the devil that he was created and made to be. He's still crooked as hell. And they know it.
Still
the devil. They know it, and you just don't know it, Latino people and black people. You just don't know it. You're the one in the dark.
Right.
See what I'm saying? You're the one in the dark. And think you're in the light. Come after what you run around the plantation. See what I'm saying? You ain't free. You are not free. Ain't no such thing as freedom in this world that we live in right now. Ain't no such thing as it. Yeah, you got to pay for something in order to get something. Ain't nothing free. Y'all okay? You beautiful. You don't put them behind your face, sister. Yeah.
We got the warrant. The warrant, huh?
Yeah. Yeah, man. See, there's another thing. Black people, Latino people, you're the most beautiful people on the face of the earth.
That's right.
Stop looking up to this white man and trying to be like the white man and white woman.
Right.
Especially for you black women.
Right.
Stop trying to be like the white woman.
Hey.
Stop wearing these blonde wigs.
Hey.
Stop getting this blonde weed put in your head.
Thank you.
See what I'm saying? Trying to look like a white woman. Don't you know, make green contacts for your eyes. Stop bleaching your skin. And they trying to be like us and you trying to be like them. They got leprosy according to the Bible.
Right.
To be blonde haired and blue eyes and a white person is leprosy according to the Bible.
Right.
Stop trying to be like the white woman and the white woman. Mainly your sister's trying to be like the white woman. Man, that kills with Beyonce. Is that Keisha Cole? Yeah, all of them blonde weeds, blonde hair. Bleaching your skin, lighten your skin.
Right.
Yeah. See a sister run around through the hood three, four times talking to me with a blonde wig on. Looking like a fool. Man, what kind of mess is that? Somebody need to tell her hair.
Then
you got some brothers running around here dyeing their hair blonde too.
Right. Man.
Looking like a fool, man.
Straight fool.
I mean, it's better than Hosea 4 and 6 up.
You don't want to wear your own hair.
Yeah, don't want to wear your own hair. You see what I'm saying?
Right.
Got all these stitches, all these wigs.
Right.
Then y'all be wearing the wig these days. Yeah, while I was growing up, women used to wear the wig. You couldn't tell it's a wig.
Right.
But y'all get the wig now and throw your hair like you're throwing the cap on. Wear a wig in the gangster league.
Way back here at the back.
The wig sitting in the back of your head. Come on,
straight
man.
Up.
It's true. That's why we laugh, but it's
straight
true.
Up. up.
Man, at least wear the wig, wear so you can't tell it's a wig.
Right, right.
Man, like the wig got its own thing going on.
And behold, Miriam became leprous.
Miriam became leprous. Remember, this is a biblical plague and a biblical disease out of the Bible. So Miriam became leprous, and what else happened to Miriam?
White as snow.
What is leprosy?
White as snow.
Leprosy is white as snow. She had her color taken away. She had her pigment taken away.
That's right.
Guess what happened to her? She got leprosy. She turned and looked. She turned, the Most High Christ turned her into a white person on the spot.
Right.
What the white people look like, white women look like today.
Right.
Blonde hair, green eyes or blue eyes,
right.
And pale is all no what. No color, no pigmentation.
Right.
That's what happened to Miriam. She was black and got turned to a white person on the spot. But going against Moses, the servant of the Most High, Moses. See? That's why we say they got leprosy. They got a biblical disease, a biblical plague when you read the Bible. And when you read the book of Leviticus, it tell you. All right, brother. It tell you about the law concerning leprosy. It tell you about the law concerning leprosy when you read the book of Leviticus. So that's why we say don't be like the white people.
Right.
Learn to love your own people. So I'm saying, learn to love each other for your black and Hispanic people.
Right.
Learn to get along with one another in the hood.
Right.
See, but then you gotta come and learn the law, statutes, and commandments that's found in the Bible.
Right.
See what I'm saying?
Right.
When you see brothers teaching like this in the street corner, when they're pulling the scriptures like this, talk with those brothers, deal with those brothers.
Right.
Now, don't get me wrong, we're not saying that we're perfect. But we do our best to treat and deal with our people righteously according to the Bible.
Uh-huh.
See what I'm saying? We make mistakes also. Every now and then we do things that are wrong. But we do our best to deal righteously with our people. So, when you see brothers out teaching, ask them questions. Learn from them. Uh-huh. Get their phone number. Check them out on YouTube. You see what I'm saying?
All
right. We got our YouTube sites. You see what I'm saying? Mine's called Halak Ahmath. This brother's called Raiya 144. This brother's called McGee Eric. See what I'm saying? Got the teachings up on YouTube. Go check it out and learn. It's okay now.
That's cool.
Yeah. See? Go and learn your history, your identity, your culture, and your traditions according to the Bible. Come out of this crap talking about I'm African American. I'm black. I'm an Asiatic black person. All that was a lies that your enemy, the so-called white man, not all the nations put on you as a people. All those things are not found in the Bible.
Right.
Africa's named after Leo Scipius Africanus.
Right.
America's named after Amerigo Vespucius. You see what I'm saying? Black is not a color. Black is not an identity. You see what I'm saying? Latino is not an identity. You don't speak Latin. Why you call yourself Latino?
Right.
The brother gave the breakdown earlier about Mexican, you see what I'm saying? All those names are proverbs and bywords that was put on us by our slave masters. Spanish Caucasian got the so-called Mexicans, and the English Caucasian got the blacks. You see what I'm saying? All the 12 tribes of the nation of Israel. That's why we scattered to the four corners of the earth. Go to James chapter 1. James 1:1. We can scatter to the four corners of the earth. And those were one of the curses that was put on us as a people by the Mosai and his son Christ for breaking his laws, statutes, and commandments. It's one of the curses. That's why James said this right here. It started upon the one of the so-called white man empires during the Romans. The Roman Caucasian, the white people, scattered us. Same way they scattered us today. And they scattered in all kind of religions, ideology, and all kind of beliefs other than the scriptures. James 1:1. Go ahead.
James, a servant of the Most High and of Hamashiach Yahushai to the 12 tribes.
James was a servant of the Most High in Christ to the 12 tribes. Go ahead. Of Israel, you black Hispanic, that's what you are. Go ahead. to the 12 tribes which were scattered abroad.
Scattered abroad because it started way back with the Romans. And it's still going on today. That's why we're in North, South, and Central America. And then that's why we're scattered to other countries throughout the world. Europe, all in the European countries. Yeah, we some of our people still over in Africa. See what I'm saying? All over to the four corners of the earth, man. Then we got scattered as a people by President Johnson joining the so-called white man military and traveling around the world and sleeping with women around the world. See what I'm saying? Scattered to the four corners of the earth like that. So we come out for the 12 lost tribes of the nation of Israel. That's who Christ came from. Give me out of Matthew chapter 15 and verse 24.
The sheep of the house of Israel.
That's why Christ said that. He's not sent but unto the lost sheep of the house of Israel, because we were scattered amongst all the, well, we were scattered during that time. Up under the Roman occupation, we were scattered then. That's why he had to say, I am not sent but unto the lost sheep of the house of Israel. The black and Latino people, you are the lost sheep of the house of Israel. Lost to that fact that's found in the Bible. You're not African American, you're not Latino, you see what I'm saying? You are the biblical Hebrew Israelite when you read the Bible. You just don't know that because they don't teach you that. Christ is a black man. The black man wrote the Bible. Colors in the Bible, Job 30 and 30, Job says, I am black. Song of Solomon 1 and 5, King Solomon says, I am black but comely. Jeremiah 8:21 says, for the hurt of the daughter of my people, I am hurt. I am black. This book is, it's okay. It's okay.
Y'all cool.
It's okay.
Y'all cool.
It's okay. Thank you, though.
That's not serious.
We're out here for y'all. It's okay. See, Jeremiah says that he's a black man. See what I'm saying? So to be black is beautiful. You see what I'm saying? It's time for our people to wake up and learn that. See what I'm saying? To be black is beautiful. Hell. I'd be glad to see black people.
That's right, brother. Love it.
Yeah, I'd be glad to see black people. I know y'all Negroes can't stand one another, but if you know what you know according to this Bible, you learn to love your people.
Right.
See what I'm saying?
Right.
And you'd be glad to see your people.
Right.
You'd be glad to share this word with your people. Yeah.
Right. That's right, Al.
Yeah. Feels good, man. Yeah. So with that, we're going to say Shabbat Shalom to our people. Shabbat Shalom to Israel.
Come
on. And
Hallelujah.
And Kwam Israel.
Shalom.
Shalom.